nobody had ever given much attention to Latin album cover art before. And I wanted to put it on the walls of a gallery to show that it's a fine art form. I just decided I would get to know some of the designers and ask them if they had any original artwork. I wanted to show not only the album covers, but the paintings and drawings and layouts that they did to achieve these covers. Today we've got computers, we don't really appreciate the craftsmanship. If you think about how they made these albums without InDesign or Quark, it's just an amazing feat. There are so many classics, of course. We have the Willie Colon, Wanted by the FBI, several Ray Barreto covers like Indestructible, Que Viva la Musica by Izzy Sanabria. There's the Tito Puente El Rey by Charlie Rosario that I absolutely love. Album covers with people dressed up in costumes by Marshall and Ron Levine. There's too many to mention, really. It's Chico Alvarez, Jorge Vargas, Yogui Rosario, Ely Besalel, and Abel Navarro.
I'm really excited to present to you Izzy Sanabria.
My name is Israel Sanabria Morales Miranda Cruz. For short, they call me Izzy. I was one of the prominent album cover designers for Latin music from the very beginning.
This is incredible because you have recognized this as an art form, and the fact that it's in a gallery up there for people to come see is you're recognizing this as art.
This is commercial art, and the art establishment doesn't consider commercial art to be art. The difference is it is art that has been enjoyed by regular people, as opposed to paintings that only people with a lot of money can afford.
This is important. It's not just about recognizing that it's real art, but that it has a sense of community.
There's nothing I would rather do than work on this show. This, to me, is a culmination of a decade of research, collecting, loving the music, and loving the art. So it was worth every minute of it.